we've sort of done our what if this happens, you know, and what are we going to do for the first 2 weeks? What will we do for, you know, an extended period beyond that as well? All of these things are yet to be determined, but technology in our fingertips is really helpful, although we worry and are concerned about the equitable access to technology and internet services in our community. So, you know, we're close at, you know, kind of rolling out our long-term plan here, but right now we just are, things are fluid, and we just think we need to get through this initial phase. Please know that I don't have my head in the sand about this, and that we are working and planning, and that we have preparation in place, and we'll be ready to serve our students the best of our possible ability.
These materials being at home, the former student in me says, well, is this going to be required? Is this going to be, so is it to just fill time for kids, or is it something that is actually part of the
program? Well, we truly hope that families will take that serious, and as they're home, you know, make sure that they are providing some academic continuity for their children and practicing, you know, the skills that they need, or getting online and seeing what we have available, or calling the school and getting those packets that we hope to have available. But we also know that that's going to depend family to family. We do want to, you know, make sure that our students who are in our advanced placement classes that are getting ready to take those advanced placement assessments in May are prepared. So we're making sure that they have their information accessible to them. We also want to make sure that we have everything available to them in terms of resources and support by keeping the teachers available starting the 23rd every day from 9 to 2 so that they can call and ask questions. All of those things are things we're doing to try to make sure that our students have as much access as they can.
Conference calls, being in the loop, ISBE Governor's Office, how much of 4 p.m. Friday was a real surprise?
You know, I wouldn't say it was a surprise. We were more surprised the day before that it didn't come. To be honest, that's why we were able to push out communications to people yesterday about taking their things home and making sure they were prepared for this. We were a little bit of the curve on that. Definitely had our platform ready to go and set up. So we were a little bit surprised that it didn't start on Monday. But it started on Tuesday, so we just went ahead and decided if it's safe for kids to be home, it's safe on Monday as well. So we're going to have our staff come in and help us prepare. So I wouldn't say it was a surprise. We didn't know the duration. We didn't know the stipulations that would go along with it. We knew that the food service was in place, so we were planning and preparing for that well in advance. So those are the kind of things that we're talking about. Now we're just really, truly thinking about all the things that maybe nobody thought about and making sure we have lists. I pretty much couldn't sleep last night thinking of the lists of things that we would need to provide.